Canada, big, wide, and very, very cold.
What?
Here in the Great White North, it snows 24 hours a day.
No.
Every day of the year.
Excuse me?
Its frozen landscape is dotted with igloos. Homes for the vast majority of Canadians. Penguins and polar bears prowl the permafrost, poaching and plundering. Of all the nerve.
Sorry to interrupt, but everything he said is wrong. You're completely wrong.
I am?
I mean, have you ever been to Canada?
Technically, no.
You know, I think that these good people deserve to hear from someone who knows the true Canada. Someone who loves Canada, who grew up there.
Is Celine Dion here?
No, Celine Dion is not here. I'm referring to myself, Martin Short. Hello. Raised in Hamilton, Ontario.
Fine. I'll just go to the France Pavilion film, where they appreciate an invisible narrator.
And you. That French. Now, I can show you the real Canada. My Canada. And there's lots to see. So let's go, shall we?
First stop, Niagara Falls. Oh, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, but Marty, those are in America. And you'd be half right. This half, however, is in Canada. The spectacular Horseshoe Falls. Now, from one natural wonder to another, check out the Bay of Fundy in New Brunswick, the largest tide in the world. Now this is low tide, obviously, when you can actually walk on the seafloor. But at high tide, you'd be 50 feet underwater. So time your walks very carefully, okay? From the east coast, we zoom across 6 time zones to the west coast. So keep your hands and feet inside the country at all times. Vancouver Island's spectacular Bouchard Gardens, inspiring visitors from around the world for over 100 years. But if you like your plants a little bigger, take a stroll through nearby Cathedral Grove. Some of the trees here are more than 800 years old. With sights like these, I'm sure it comes as no surprise that Canadians love the great outdoors. Especially these Canadians. I suppose the polar bears are a bit of a giveaway that we do get a little snow in Canada. But you know what? It doesn't slow us down. Not one bit. And okay, sometimes I do get a little excited about curling, but who doesn't?
Sweet, 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 sweet!
In winter, skating is our favorite form of transportation, like here on the Rideau Canal in Ottawa.
I was practically born on skates. In fact, I just happen to have some footage from my glory days in peewee hockey. Isn't it great that my parents owned a circle vision camera? What are the odds?
Don't pass it to Marty!
Hey, that's me!
Oh, no! He never scores!
Well, I think you can clearly see my early potential. Sure, I could have gone pro, the dream of every young Canadian. But I decided to go into comedy instead. Ah! Looks like things are warming up.
But that's okay, because when the snow melts, Canadians are just as passionate about warm weather sports. Here in Nova Scotia, our passion is sailing. This is the home of the legendary Blue Nose, winner of 4 international races in her day. We're so proud of her, we put her image on a coin. Check it out the next time you accidentally get a Canadian dime in your change. Yes, Canadians do treasure nature and the great outdoors. And with such colorful small towns as Moose Jaw and Medicine Hat, some people might think we're rustic backwoods folks. But in fact, most Canadians live in cities. Come on, I'll show you. Here's beautiful Victoria, British Columbia. The architecture of this charming city is so inspired by its British heritage that you would swear you were in England. Victoria's nearest neighbor is Vancouver. This diverse cosmopolitan city is nestled between a rainforest, coastal mountains, and the Pacific Ocean. It's also home to Canada's exciting film industry. Now that's talent. Next stop is Calgary, gateway to the Rocky Mountains, where sophisticated city living is right around the corner from outdoor adventure. And if you visit in July, don't forget to pack your chaps and spurs.
Yeehaw! Ha ha! The Calgary Stampede, in the saddle since 1912, with bucking broncos, wagon races, and bull riding.
Let me show you how it's done.
Get along, little doggy! From the height of the Rockies to the height of sophistication, Toronto.
This is a truly creative city, filled with theaters, museums, and nightlife. The highlight of the year is the Toronto International Film Festival, where stars and fans from all over the world arrive for premieres and parties.
C'est magnifique!
Oh, I know, you're probably thinking, hey Marty, what's with the French? Well, it's because now we are in Quebec, the cradle of French civilization in North America. Quebec City is the only walled city in Canada. But the largest city in the Province du Québec is Montreal. In fact, it's the largest French-speaking city outside of France. Elle est très belle, non? A little help for the monolinguals in the audience. Merci. Montreal is the home of the little theater group you just might be familiar with.
Cirque du Soleil was created on the sidewalks of Quebec by street performers in 1984. Today it has shows all over the world.
And speaking of talented performers, here are a few other Canadians you might recognize. Wait, aren't we missing the most glamorous one of all?
Ah, that's better. Well, I guess you can say entertainers are Canada's most important export. But let me introduce you to the real stars of Canada. The people who make up one of the most diverse countries in the world.
From our native people to our newest immigrants, we treasure that diversity. But no matter who we are, we're all proud to be Canadian. This would be a perfect place for a song. I think so, don't you?
Canada.
Here we are at Niagara Falls again. We've come full circle, and sadly, our journey has come to an end.
Well, I just hope you enjoyed your tour of my Canada. But there's nothing like the real thing. So just walk outside the theater, hook a left toward that big silver ball, and keep walking due north. You can't miss it. Just tell them Marty sent you. No. How do I get out of here? Because I have a fast pass for Sora.
Hate to miss it.
I need help!
Welcome back, travelers. I hope you enjoyed your tour of my Canada. Please gather your personal belongings and move through those open doors. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your day here in Epcot.